Hello everyone, today we are going to learn a very interesting topic and I really hope that you will enjoy this topic. I'll move the camera little near the board. Here it is perfect. Now today's topic that we are going to learn is really interesting and as well as it is really easy for all of you to understand. So the topic is area and perimeter. Now area and perimeter is a really easy topic and I know most of you may know it, but today we are going to know it of circle. Now we know of square, we know of rectangle, we know of triangle, even of other quadrilaterals, but we are really having problem with the circle. So today we are going to start with area, perimeter of the circle. Okay, now I'll start. First of all, we have to know, like here, I have drawn a circle right now. Now, what is perimeter? We actually know perimeter is the boundary. So the boundary is known as the perimeter. But what about this inner thing? So this inner thing inside the circle is the area. Now of rectangle and square we tell it as perimeter. But of circle the perimeter is known as circumference. So circumference is the term that we all use for the perimeter of the circle or the boundary. Now we have to know the rules or the steps to follow for finding the perimeter, even the area of this circle. So here we go. Now here we have the formula. The first formula that we have is 2 pi r. Now what is 2 pi r exactly? Now in this we have a term known as pi, which is exactly new to us. Now what is pi? Pi is basically two forms which we use in either type of questions. So the first form is 3.14, which is the basic form. And the other which can be used is 22 over 7. So it depends on our equation or the question if we have to use 3.14 as pi or 22 upon 7 as pi. So what we have to do, we have to multiply 2 with pi, whichever pi do we use. Multiplied with r. Now what is this r? This is the radius. This is the radius. So we have to multiply 2 into pi into radius. Now this is for finding the circumference of the circle. Now we have a circle and we want to find this. We need to know its radius. Now next we have is pi r square. Now again pi's value will be any of these. And it will be pi into r, means radius into r. This is how do we find the area of a circle. We have pi and it is r square, so we will multiply r 2 times. So now I will explain you with the help of an example. So here I am taking an example. You can note this down in your notebooks if you want. So for example, in a question I have a circle with the radius of 5 cm and I have to find its circumference. So first of all, it is easier for us to calculate if we draw a rough diagram. So for example, over here I am drawing a rough diagram which is my circle. So I have to find the circumference of the circle which I am holding, and from the center this is the radius which is the 5 cm of the circle. Now we'll find the steps and the application of 2 pi r rule. And in this case, we have radius as 5 cm. So it is up to us if we have to decide to take 3.14 or 22 over 7. So I recommend using 3.14 in these type of questions. Otherwise, if you have a number divisible with 7, then you use the 22 over 7 rule. So we will take 2, which is into the rule. We'll take pi as 314, which was 3.14, and removing the point, we will add 100 and we will multiply it with our radius, which is 5. Now the rest of the work we have to do is cutting different digits with different numbers. Here we have 5 and 100, so we can cut this at 1 and 20. Now we have 2 and 20, so we can cut this at 10 and 1. Now we are left with 314/10. This can be further divisible on the table of 2. So we will cut it. 10 comes at 5 and 31. Now this is a big number. If you are in a bigger grade, you can solve it mentally. If you are in a smaller grade, I'll tell you how to divide this. Just a minute, let me erase some of this. Okay, here I have made space. Now we'll divide 314 with 2. So we'll write it, we'll divide it the way we do. So we have 14 at the last, which comes at 7. So we have 157. Now here we will write 157. So we are left with 157/5, which are not divisible. So our circumference is 157/5. This is our final answer, which is our circumference of this circle. Now the answer may come in the fraction form. You can change it into the decimal form, or it is upon you, you have to change it into a mixed fraction form. Now this is how we find the perimeter using the formula 2 pi and r, in which we take 2, we multiply it with pi, and then we multiply it with the radius, which we had 5. So the circumference of this particular circle has come as 157/5, which we can convert in further into the decimal form. So now we find the area of a particular circle. We have the formula, which is pi r square. Now as usual, I'll take an example. Now for example, in my example now, we have the radius as 28 cm. Now we will find the area of a circle with the radius 28 cm. We'll draw a rough diagram to depict this. Now let's draw the rough diagram. So here we have a circle right over here. We have a center point. We have the radius L, which is 28 cm, and we have to find the area. This is how we draw a rough diagram for the perimeter and area concept. Now let's find of the formula says pi r square. Now in this we have a radius which is divisible by 7. So we will take it as 22/7. Inu 28, inu 28. So we can cut this at 1 and 28 will get at 4. Now we have the denominator as 1, so we don't need to cut any more. We just need to multiply 22 into 4 into 28, which is 2, 4, 6, 4. So our final, which is the area of this particular circle, has come to 4, 6, 4 cm². Don't forget to put the square, because this is the area and we have to put the square automatically. Now this is the area. Now I'm sure you will be able to know what is perimeter of circle. It is the circumference of the circle, and how, as well as how to find the circumference of the circle, the formula and the way and the application and the rules to follow. And the next thing, which is the area, which is pi r square, we know this, and we have to find the application. This is totally clear. So thank you. Bye bye.